Hey, guys. Good morning. Sorry I'm late. Afraid I got lost on the path of life.
Alright, another devilogue. I was not trying to take this long to upload it, but it was necessary. I had to wait. Alright, and I'm glad I did. So, I worked on a lot of things, mostly Blender still, but I made a new font system, and it is pretty cool. I'm not going to say anything, I'm just going to let you watch the video, okay? But it's pretty cool. It's my best work yet. Alright, so I started building the fire station, just the block out area. I didn't record it, but I built the post office in front of it as well, whatever this place is called. Just so whenever I can make sure that when I make the roads, I can make sure the turn is perfect and everything is aligned how it should be. I then moved on to one of the buildings I already created so I can optimize it, make sure I lower the triangle count as much as possible, separate it into different pieces, that way whenever I UV unwrap it, I have the same texture density for each mesh part and we don't have any problems in the future. I also started doing the same thing for the smaller objects. Just make sure we reduce the triangle count as much as possible and get it to a game asset ready. And so we can texture it and import it into Roblox Studios and make sure our texture density is also good. So we don't have any problems. We're trying to make sure our performance is good. So I'm trying to do my best to make sure we reduce the lag as much as possible. All right, here's our first gun model for the game. That is a sexy gun right there. But we have a sight for it. I modeled it. We're still gonna make a flashlight and other attachments. You'll be able to customize your guns in the game, of course. So I'll make a bunch of attachments for all of the guns. But our first one is done, looking clean. We got our UV and wrap it. Make sure our texture density is good, of course. And texture it, and then we can script it later on. I don't know how to script guns, but I'll figure it out. It can't be that hard. It's only R15 and third person. How hard can that be?
Figure something out, I guess.
All right, but it's looking pretty clean. First gun, awesome. We need to make some more now. All right, I wanted to update the phone system as well, so I made a new phone model for it as well. It's not an iPhone 15.
Is that so?
And it looks great so far. Now I'm just gonna texture it, and then we can add it into Studio. I got done texturing the phone model. I added it into Roblox Studios and then I turned it into a tool and it came out great. No issues. It works perfectly fine. And then I also set up the screen GUI for the actual player to see or for the client to see. And it came out awesome. Amazing. And I also made this cool animation, which is pretty cool. It's neat. I tried to use a video frame for this, but it didn't work. And plus, you need like 2,000 Robux for it to actually upload a video frame, so I can't really test it. So I just did it the manual way, and it works. So, pretty cool. Alright, so here's our new phone system. So if I pull it out here, we have a cool animation, like so. It looks awesome.
Wonderful!
No issues. We have a 12-hour clock instead of a 24-hour clock. The 24-hour clock will still be in the game, like you can have settings and change it. 24-hour clock or military time, whatever you want to call it. But you'll be able to change this to whatever you prefer. And we can always, and any part of our screen, you can always, like a normal phone, you can access your menu appear. All of these will work. Well, you can turn these on and off, but they won't really do anything because airplane mode is no point for it. But I'll still add it in there. And then our flashlight works as well, as you can see. Pretty cool. We can turn it off and on. No issues. It works for the server, so everyone can see it on the server. And same for your phone color. So we can unlock our phone now. And boom. And we gotta set up the home screen and everything else. But we can change the color of our phone as well. So we can go in our app over here. And you can pick any color you want. And you can see, let's turn our flash off. And you can see it changes our texture for the phone. No problems. And whenever we close the phone and put it out, it has its own separate animation. So pull it out. Our phone's green now. Change it to a different color. Put it away. And pull it out, it's pink now. Okay, so everything has its own animation. It works perfectly fine. Pretty cool so far. It also works for the controller as well. So if I get my controller here, as you can see, we're on controller. We can pull out our phone. It comes out, pretty cool. Now, I want to re-keybind everything because in order to use GUIs on the controller, you have to click the touchpad or whatever button you have for your controller and you get just cursor here. Which I don't like because it disables the player's movement and you have to sit here and it highlights a big box of it, everything, and I hate it, but it still works. I just don't like the way this default controls are, so we're gonna re-keybind everything and use like the arrow keys to navigate your phone. You know, it makes it easier, and that way you don't gotta disable your controller just to disable your can movement that to use your phone. So yeah, we're gonna re-keybind everything so that way it's easier to use and you don't have to stop running just to use your phone. You can just pull it out and then you'll be able to use it with the arrow keys just like GTA does. Okay, so I'll change all of that for the controller as well. I imported some buildings as well, as you can see. Just see what it looks like. It looks awesome. Just need textures. Once we add in the rest of the objects, it will look perfect. It'll look amazing. I'm telling you, it'll look great. This is cool so far. No issues. And yeah, that's pretty much it. New phone system looking very clean. All right, so that's basically it. We don't need to do anything else now, but it's pretty cool. I know performance will probably be a big issue, but I'm working on it. It's fine. I'm gonna make sure y'all have every setting that messes with lag and performance in the game so you can turn it off. Like, I want to use Roblox terrain, so I'm gonna make sure you'll be able to turn the grass off and make sure we have different texture set levels, so medium, high, and low. I control the textures, so I can do that. I can get different texture sets in the game, and we can also make sure we have turn the shadows off for all of the objects and the lighting and everything else. Okay, I got y'all covered.
No problem, I got you, fam.
Don't worry, I'm gonna try my best to reduce the performance and make sure it's actually playable for people that, you know, low-end PCs. So yeah, try my best. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Like, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one.
That's all for now, folks. Now watch how a pro exits. Like he's got somewhere to be!
Okay, you guys, that is a hero!